Type 1 diabetes is a 24/7, 365 days a year disease. You get no breaks, no holidays.
What happens in type 1 diabetes is that your immune system starts to recognize your beta cells as foreign. And because they recognize it as foreign, they'll then go and attack them and kill them. The problem then becomes, how do you get more? If we could give beta cells back to a patient who is diabetic, that would be a way of treating their diabetes. My lab focuses on how to make more beta cells. We would like to be able to define the genes that let beta cells replicate. And then by defining those genes, then we can make drugs that can activate or shut off those genes.
In our lab, there's four of us that have diabetes. It's more than just a research group, but a group that we can feed off of each other, learn from each other, and learn how to manage our diabetes.
I was 20 years old when I was diagnosed with type 1 diabetes. I was serving my LDS mission in St. Petersburg, Russia.
I was diagnosed with diabetes on my 15th birthday.
I was diagnosed in December of 2006. I was 16 years old at the time.
I was diagnosed on my birthday in Brazil while I was serving an LDS mission.
So we're looking at a section of a pancreas from a mouse. The red staining is for insulin. The blue simply is just staining for the nuclei. And then the green is showing a protein, P57, which is a cell cycle inhibitor. In someone with type 1 diabetes, you would see little to no red because the red represents the beta cells and insulin.
The most encouraging thing is that we're actually seeing proliferation. We're seeing these beta cells grow, divide, and secrete insulin.
I'm confident that in the next couple of decades that a cure for diabetes will be found.